I grew up as a very bitter child. Bitter with God, bitter with life. And there are those times that I wish we were all dead. You know, there are times I was contemplating if there was a way I could kill everybody in my family so that we don't go through the kind of life that we are going through. My name is Maureen Kaderi. I was born in Kariobangi. Life was not so easy, especially as a girl child and as a baby in the slum. Poverty brings bondage, where you tend to feel like, this is me, and this is how I live, and this is how I die. My mom was not working, my dad was a casual laborer. The days he was working, he would get like $10 a month, and our house was $6. So you can imagine how we would survive with $4. So life was unbearable. So we went for 4 or 5 days without eating, and if we had to eat food, it was rotten, that we had gone to pick from Korogosho market. You cannot concentrate on an empty stomach. And so many of the times I would be last in class. I had names like I was called Hyena because every time people were eating, I would go and ask them to give me food. At home, when it rained, it was the worst time of our lives as a family because the floor was not cemented. Our bed was our clothes, our own tattered clothes that we'll put down. And so when it rains, we'll go look for a corner, stand there. And the little books that I have, the uniform that I have, if it has been rained on, I would cry because the teachers would not understand that this is my situation. We didn't have any direction. We didn't have any tomorrow. There's no ray of hope in everything that is happening in my life. So that actually even made me hate myself so much and hate God. But the moment I joined Compassion, when I was 7 years old, my life changed. The Compassion Project was a second family to me, where I received even more love, you know, and care at a very personal level. I received hope in Compassion. And you know, that is where I was taught how to pray. I got my first Bible and I was taught how to read the Bible and believe in the words that were written in the Bible. And whatever I was taught to the Compassion Project, I will take it back home. I was so happy after the first Saturday because of the balanced diet. I was always looking forward to every Saturday because it was like Christmas to me and my family. There is power in food and there is power in opportunity. Compassion bought for me with the money that my sponsor sent, uniform, books, paid my school fees, so I was not off. I was always in class, not missing anything. Clean, at least with clean uniform. I had shoes on, new ones. And I started working hard. I got, yes, education, academics, which helped, but also these other livelihood skills, which kinda empowered me, transformed me, and brought my self-worth. I started believing that I can do something. You know, my dreams are valid. All these things is because of what I learned from the Compassion Project. I remember the first time I got a picture, a photo of my sponsors and a letter. I was so excited. And from then I started saying, I don't care. I'm not a hyena. I believed in myself, and I believe that I was beautiful, and I started loving myself. And the letter continued that I want you to know that we love you so much. We are always praying for you. When I joined university, my mom was so happy and so proud. She was so grateful to Compassion, so grateful. She loved Compassion, and she kept saying that whatever Compassion did, she could not have done. I am who I am today because of compassion. What I went through has shaped who I am right now and what I do. I started Rehema House, a Christian, a non-profit organization which rescues young, poor, pregnant girls from the streets and slums of Kenya. To me, Rehema is a baby of compassion. There's counseling, there's discipleship, there's mentorship. We have people working with them. I love these girls and I connect everything happening with my story because that's why I'm thankful for my background. If I never went through what I went through, I will not give the girls my all. I know what it means to go hungry for days. These girls, that is what they're facing right now. I'm able to fit in their shoes. I love when they come and hug us and say, thank you for loving me so well. So these kids always encourage me when I just look at them and see their life is a pure miracle because most of their parents wanted to abort them or commit suicide. You don't have to be rich to have a good impact. There is power, let me tell you. There is power in holding other people's hands. That is what Compassion did. That is what my sponsors did. It's hope that trickles down to the family, to the community, and to the world. And I look at myself as a world changer.